direct your attention to the Northwest Tunnel and welcome your Tampa Bay Buccaneers. All right, fans, let's hear it from the offensive starters of Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Your starting wide receiver. And taking the field, your starting quarterback.
Gus Johnson, with Chris Collinsworth, a picture-perfect day in Tampa, Florida, as we welcome you to the Ray J, Raymond James Stadium. Postseason advancement on the line here in this playoff battle between the Chicago Bears and Tampa Bay Buccaneers. The Bears.
Playing on the road, always a difficult place to win. What does the traveling team have to do?
Well, Gus, there's no question that not only do you have to overcome a terrific football team, but you have to overcome one of the toughest environments in the National Football League. So emotionally, you almost have to find your own energy on the field. The bench has to be alive. You have to be cheering for each other. You just have to create that raw emotion to overcome what the crowd is giving you on the other side.
All right, Chris, with that in mind, let's go down to the field. We are ready for football. Colquitt will be kicking this one off to get us started. Julian Peterson was there to bring him down. And coming to the field, the quarterback, who hopes to lead this offense to victory in this game. He's going to run with it. And when you look at this offense and some of their key players, you realize that with guys like Matt Forte from Tulane, they're going to use a power running game.
Yeah, you're going to need more than one guy to bring down Matt Forte. He's a tough, bruising running back that really is the embodiment of the position.
And Chris, he is definitely primed to be a performer to watch in this one.
Defense is the recipe for success for this team, and they've enjoyed a lot of it. Of course, it all starts with exceptional strong safety, the Tasmanian Devil, Troy Polamalu out of USC.
Yeah, I don't know what more you can say about Troy Polamalu that hasn't been said 100 times. He's just one of the best, and maybe one of the best ever, and he's probably ticketed for the Hall of Fame. I know that is high praise, but when you watch him play, he can just do so much, and his instincts seem to always take him to the ball.
And the tackle was made by DJ Moore. So now the quarterback comes onto the field, and in conversations with him earlier in the week, he mentioned that he really wanted to get going early and get into a rhythm. Let's see if he can do just that. They keep it on the ground with the tailback.
And let's spotlight the offensive key players. Running back Peyton Hillis out of Arkansas has become a sensation, grinding out those tough yards between the tackles.
And it doesn't always have to be pretty to be effective, and Peyton Hillis is one of the hardest working running backs in the league. You know, not only is he so tough to bring down, but he has acceleration into the hole, and that is really underrated.
And Chris is definitely primed to be a performer to watch in this one. We're still locked up at zero as we head to the second quarter. Welcome back to Tampa.
Good gain on the ground, which will set up another first and 10. They'll keep it on the ground again. And he's tackled around the 20-yard line by Casey. Brings up second and 9. Ball on the 20-yard line. They give it off here. He's brought down around the 15-yard line by number 99. Just about 4 yards shy of the first here on third down. Hillis gets a call. Jabal Sheard with his first rush of the game. So they'll go from the 11.
Well, that was the perfect time for them to call a blitz. They got in there, filled up all the gaps, brought down the running back for a short gain.
They'll give it off here. Not much, maybe 2 yards on the carry. Just 5 yards away from a touchdown now. Hillis gets it on the inside. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. 4 yards there on that touchdown score. It looks like they will go for two. Number 15, pitch out. Powers in for the two-point conversion. Great job there. They were able to get it in for two.
And you could tell the offense had a plan throughout that drive. Not only did they get the touchdown, but they immediately got the call in for the two-point conversion. They knew exactly what they wanted to do and executed it perfectly.
Tampa Bay is ready to kick this one off. Rucker is back to receive the kick. Zbikowski was there for the stop. The defense played exceptionally well the last time this offense had the ball. They'll start this drive at the 18-yard line. And we'll have a first down and 10. A lot of movement down there on the offensive line.
Well, that's more than a little humiliating for an offensive lineman. Unfortunately, there's nowhere to hide after one of those. And, yeah, they know national television is going to be talking about them as well.
Forte gets the ball.
The Bears are not doing a good job at all on the ground so far. They need to somehow get that turned around, because if you can't run it, boy, it is tough to throw the football.
They hand it off.
The Bears are simply getting stuffed on nearly every rushing attempt. They need to get a spark somehow, because this just does not bode well for them.
Forte on the right side. The stop was made by Champ Bailey. Fourth down. The Bears are lining up to punt this one away.
If we don't make a play, we're not gonna win.
Weddle fields it at the 48. He brings it out to the 39. Bird was there to bring him down. The offense will start at the 39-yard line. It's first and 10. Throws to his right. It's knocked down. Excellent play by the defender.
Well, this is a guy who's known for taking some risks, but that was an unnecessary risk there. Lucky that wasn't intercepted.
Looking end zone as time runs out. That brings up third and 10. The ball is on the 39-yard line. Still looking for an open man. And we've come to halftime here. The score at the halfway mark is 8-0. Welcome back to Tampa. Tampa Bay will get it first here in the second half. Gets it to the 21. Bird was there. For the stop. They'll set up shop at the 21-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Takes the snap, and he's in trouble.
Number 15 on the carry. 1 yard loss.
Second down and 7 yards to go. Number 15 hands it off.
Number 40.
Yeah, sometimes you just have to admit defeat on a play as a running back and just try and get that thing back to the line of scrimmage.
Makes the throw over the middle. He's dropped down around the 41-yard line by number 47. And so far in this one, as you can see, this player has been the impact performer of the game so far. First down and 10. Ball on their own 41. A pickup of about 7. They'll need about 3 yards here on second down. So, at the end of 3, our score: the Buccaneers, 8. The Bears, 0. Welcome back to Tampa. The Buccaneers have a 1-touchdown lead and the ball as we start the final quarter. Fire.
gives it off. He's tackled right around the 36-yard line by Jennings. Now we have a first down and 10 to go. Number 15 hands it off straight ahead. And the tackle was made by Lance Briggs. 2nd and 6 yards to go. They're on their 33. Up the middle. Corey Wooten was there to bring him down. They pick up a chunk of about 6 yards. So that'll bring up third down. Just a couple of inches away from picking up this first down. Here's the give. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. Lance Briggs was there for the stop. And we'll have a first down and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. The Buccaneers just took their first time out. He gets another carry. He's wrestled down at about the 25-yard line by number 55. So they'll face a 2nd and 10. Number 15, hands off. It's a gain of 4. The offense has looked very good on third down so far on this drive. Going 2 for 2. Let's see what happens here. Flips it out short. The stop was made by Matt Asiata. That is a big-time pass.
Yeah, especially considering that they have the lead, and now they really... have the clock and the scoreboard on their side.
The Buccaneers just need to make sure they don't turn it over here, and they can lock up the NFC Championship. Next up, the Super Bowl. Number 15 gives it up the middle. Nice running for a gain of 6. The Buccaneers will take their last time out. The Buccaneers just need to make sure they don't turn it over here, and they can lock up the NFC Championship. Next up, the Super Bowl. Pitch right. He's in! Touchdown! And he adds the point after. Tampa Bay looks ready to kick it away. Rucker stands back to field the kick. He'll take it from the 2. He gets out to about the 22-yard line. Fujita was there to bring him down. They'll go to work at the 22.
It's first and 10. He's searching for a receiver. Short pass to his left. It's a fumble. Chicago is able to fall on it.
You have to protect the ball. It's really just as simple as that. You cannot have turnovers and expect to be successful in a game like this.
Third and short situation now. They'll need a couple of yards to convert. They'll throw for the first. He's looking over the top. The pass is tipped away. And the pass is knocked away at the last minute.
Well, at the end of the game, you go back and you basically say, what happened on third down? And you have a pretty good indication of how that game came out. Good play by the defense.
They didn't get it. Incomplete pass. That'll do it from Raymond James Stadium. Stick around for the top highlights from this game. And let's take a look at the Gatorade Performer of the Game.
Consent is prohibited.
The AFC playing on their home field, and they want to be able to keep this advantage going. As we get ready for this one, Chris, what is the key in this matchup?
Well, and I think you hit on it, Gus, the home field advantage, because these two teams obviously... match up very well against each other. So as the home team, you're hoping that you can sort of incite your own fans and get that energy in the building, because in a game this close, that well could be the difference.
All right, Chris, with that in mind, let's go down to the field. We are ready for football. Thomas was there for the stop. So now the quarterback comes onto the field, and in conversations with him earlier in the week, he mentioned that he really wanted to get going early and get into a rhythm. Let's see if he can do just that. Play action. He's got time. It starts with the sensational Andre Johnson out of the University of Miami, who just may be the best wide receiver in football.
I am going to totally agree with that statement. There are a lot of good ones out there, but I think he is the best. And I'm not sure that there's any other receiver that can match the combination of all the skills that he has, the strength, speed, hand-eye coordination, and just the competitive nature that he brings to the game.
And Chris, he is definitely primed to be a performer to watch in this one.
Goes through his progression. Throws it up top, down the left side. Not able to make the catch in traffic.
And as we take a look at some of the key defenders, we look at John Beeson out of Miami.
And Gus, when you look at what he's done in his career so far, you realize it is no fluke. He's the perfect combination of size and speed for what you want in a linebacker in today's game.
And that's good quarterback play. He recognized the blitz, he understood what was happening with the coverage behind it, and found the open man.
Still looking for an open man. Has a man out to his right. He's brought down right around the 42-yard line by Grimes. Throws to his left. Another catch on this drive. He powers into the end zone for a touchdown. A.J. Green was there for the 40-yard touchdown reception. Rob Baronis puts it through, and it's a 7-point game. Baronis is ready to kick this one off. Harvin is deep, looking to return the kickoff. He makes it to the 23-yard line. Algeron Verner was there to bring him down. They'll start this drive at the 23. First down, 10 to go. Romo with the give. He's dropped down right around the 24-yard line by Harper. It's now 2nd and 9. Inside handoff. He's tackled at about the 33-yard line by Harper. It's 3rd down now and just about the length of the football away from the first down marker. He fights forward to about the 36. Daquan Bowers was there for the stop. And we'll have a 1st down and 10. Fires a laser down the middle. They can't complete the pass, and now the offense will be looking at 2nd down. So, from their own 36-yard line. Fires a strike to the right. And he's tackled right around midfield by Jackson. He's going to his right. Throws. And the tackle was made by Algeron Verner.
The quarterback found his man there and picks up a big gain through the air. Chris, how did he get open on that play?
Well, Gus, this guy is known for being a ball hog, but sometimes if a defensive back tries to make a play on the ball, he'll come up short and leave his receiver open for a big gain, and I think that's exactly what we saw there.
It'll be interesting to see how he plays him for the rest of the game.
It's a 2nd and 11 situation here. They spot it on the 34-yard line. throws it to the middle.
And the halfback was open on that one. The quarterback just missed it.
So another third down coming up for the offense. Surveys the field. Caught! Touchdown!
There aren't too many better options than that guy when you're talking about throwing one in the end zone. Some of the best hands in all of football.
And this for the tie. Robbie Gould puts it through to tie the game. Number two looks ready to kick it away. Smith stands back to field the kick. This will be down to the end zone for a touchback. The AFC got the ball into the end zone on their last possession. They'll get the ball here at the 20-yard line. It's first and 10. Passes short right side. He's wrestled down right around the 22-yard line by Black. It's a second and 8 situation now. He's brought down right around the 44-yard line by Grimes. The first half comes to a close with our score all tied up. And we'll see how this one turns out as we're set to get the second half underway. He'll down it in the end zone. The offense will take over at the 20. First down and 10. They'll give it off here. The stop was made by Rasheed Mathis. 4-yard gain.
Gain of 4 on the play.
Second and 6 yards to go. Ball on their own 24. Hillis gets the call again. And the tackle was made by Ryan Taylor. Short yardage situation here. They'll need a little less than a yard to convert. Hillis on the handoff. And it's a quick three and out.
And three and outs are embarrassing for an offense. When you go out there and run three plays and have to go jogging back to your sideline, those defensive guys, they aren't too happy.
He's looking down the middle. Throws.
It is so hard to complete passes like that on fourth down because there's no mystery about what you're going to have to do. And especially in those long yardage situations, you have to execute perfectly, and that's exactly what they did.
And so far in this one, as you can see, this player has been the impact performer of the game so far.
The NFC have possession of the ball and are looking to get at least 3 points on the drive to break the tie. They hand it off. Kelvin Hayton was there to bring him down. A 5-yard gain. And just about 4 yards away here on second down. Hillis gets it on the inside.
That was because the defense filled up all the gaps. The back was looking for somewhere to run, but by bringing the run blitz, they took away all the holes and stopped them for a minimal gain.
Romo, hands off. They needed the first on that play, and he delivered.
Nice run on third down that time. Boy, you can tell the confidence they have in this running back. They're going to feed him the ball in difficult situations, and he came through there.
On the ground with the tailback. He's dropped down right around the 40-yard line by Harper. They'll face second down and 10. We're down to our final minute of this game. Hillis on the run. He's tackled around the 29-yard line by Jackson. Now we have a first down and 10 to go. Ball on the 29-yard line. The halfback with the carry. Aaron Smith was there for the stop. We've got second and 9 yards to go. Hillis again.
And when your defensive line can handle their guys up front and not allow the offensive lineman to get down on the linebackers, it really gives those linebackers a chance to look great.
It's third down, 9 yards to go. Hillis gets another carry. Rasheem Mathis was there to bring him down. And here we go. The kicker has a chance to be a hero. The kick is good. So the score now, the NFC 10, the AFC 7. That's going to do it. We have highlights coming right up, so don't go anywhere. And let's take a look at the Gatorade performer of the game.
This telecast is copyrighted by the NFL for the private use of our audience, any other use of this telecast or of any pictures, descriptions, or accounts of the game without the NFL's consent is prohibited.